Guardian, you'll be pleased to hear that Elizabeth has finally come around to our way of thinking, as I knew she would. She will assist your infiltration of the orbital station, a feat made possible now that I have decrypted the codes for the launch pods. Unfortunately, despite the reintegration of both the Malahayati and Charlemagne submines, Rasputin remains incapable of self-restoration. There is simply too much missing code for its internal algorithm to fill in the rest on its own. We require more data. Infiltrate the vaults and retrieve it. The more data you obtain, the faster Rasputin's protocols can facilitate its reconstruction. Do not tarry. You can be assured that our enemies won't.
Time to snag another submine fragment, Guardian. Get in and out before they even know what's hit them.
Memory fragmented at best.
I woke up attached to my badge. Got caught up chasing the promises of the Golden Age before I learned about who you really were.
And now you're taking on my life's work as your own. It seems you truly will always be a prey.
Uh-huh.
I've been reviewing the data from your previous infiltrations of the launch facility, as well as schematics of the Seraph station. Here's where we're at. Anna can remotely inject malicious code into the launch pods. That will allow you to dock at the Seraph station without drawing fire from its defense systems. We only have one window of opportunity to do this before House Salvation figures out what we're up to. No room for error. Once you're aboard the station, I'll guide you to the Warmind Integration Core. There, we'll upload a virus into its system. The virus will hold open a backdoor to the Seraph station's network. We can remotely transfer control of the station to Rasputin once he's ready. We have no idea what the Hive or House Salvation have done to the station, so we'll need to think on our feet and act quickly. But that's what you're best at.
Everything is in place. I've routed you as straight a path to the launch platform as I could. I don't believe our enemies are aware of what we're attempting, but you should still prepare for heavy resistance. I've gained remote access to the launch facility's subsystems, but someone is already in here. House Salvation splicers are hacking the launch mainframe. You need to find a splicer and liberate the security scanner protocol from them. I won't be able to secure the launch without it. Protocol you've picked up. It should automatically detect which consoles have been tampered with and highlight them. It'll also highlight other tampered devices, so keep an eye out. Now, get us access to those terminals, and I'll have Anna perform a remote hack from here. System cleared. Launch codes accepted. Priming the pods for launch. Get in! can't believe it. You're actually on Seraph Station. Feed looks good. Receiving you loud and clear.
You should be able to decompile your scanner protocol at that terminal by the door to gain access. You're on the far end of the station, so we have a lot of ground to cover. Let's get moving. Scanner protocol is offline. Keep an eye out for splicers who have new scanner protocol codes.
Thank you.
so that's definitely a trap. But the splicers must be able to get through there. Maybe the scanner protocol can reveal something.
Protocol should allow you to remotely access those red highlighted panels by shooting them with your gun. I'm not sure why they're designed like that, and at this point, I'm almost afraid to ask. bypass security, but I think I have an idea. Play along. You need to surrender to House Salvation. One of Aramis's captains has put an order to bring you in alive so that he can present you to her as a trophy. Make some noise to draw their attention. It'll help sell the bluff. She's here? Of course. That must be how Zubarov plans on co-opting the Warsat network. The Hive can't do it on their own, so the Witness sends Aramis and her splices in to assist.
Let's go.
Transmat access acquired. Weapons incoming. Neutralize the crew and get to the front of the catch. Going to need to jump carefully to get back down to the station. I know that Scorn. He's one of Aramis's lieutenants, but he died on Europa.
His name was Praxis, and you killed him. But the Witness has returned him to us, as it will return all Elixni slain by the machine Spawn's hand.
Console. House Salvation has more ships inbound.
Initiated a station-wide security reboot. It should disable orbital defenses and clear an exit.
About a half dozen House Salvation catches inbound. Get to your ship and get out of there.
Got it.
Alright. Let's get this bread.
Fallen. First those scavengers sully my facilities on Europa, and now they're scurrying aboard the Seraph station. Unacceptable. Who knows what kind of havoc they might wreak? The technology their splicers could damage or destroy. I will see those vermin exterminated and the Warsats returned to our control. But first, we must finish reconstructing Rasputin. At present, it is in no condition to be uploaded to the Warsat network. Continue retrieving submine data for reintegration. In the meantime, I will search for a more expedient way to restore Rasputin. Once again, it falls to me to act as humanity's savior.
Damn, I only give you 10. Wow. Okay, I was not expecting the exotic outright. Okay, let's just erase one of these. Ooh, ambitious. Okay, I'll keep that. No, that's fine. I don't need this one. I guess I'm just more surprised they just give it to you outright. I was expecting more. A series of automated beeps emit from the dormant exo frame on a nearby screen. A small prompt appears. Remote download initiated. It's a message. Start with the bait and switch mate needed to secure deliver. This data house salvation is monitoring my long-range communication. I am Agent Fen 092 of the Hidden, contacting you regarding your recent discovery aboard Seraph Station. I've reviewed our records, and it appears that there was a weapon Raytech was developing in conjunction with another contemporary corporation of the time, one of an unusual adaptive design. Now the weapon you retrieve from the station is hundreds of years old and barely held together. That said, the Hidden have access to an artifact that may be able to draw out the secrets of the past within it. Would you kindly bring this weapon to Mars? All right. I'm gonna use it, obviously. Man, this weapon looks nice though, dog. It also feels weird. because it's a deep sight. Alright, less stable burst to too high. Oh, that's filthy. You can turn it into an aggressive or... Okay. Okay. Strong against barrier champions? Bro. Man, they really were just like, let's just make something fun. Mercury's went crazy with it. Alright. So that's it for the story. Oh, we can go in there? So, casually just go in there all the time, I guess? I'm fucking 1593. I'm down to do this. Heavily shielded and highly aggressive. Combatants appear in great numbers. Radar is disabled. Combatants have more health and more difficult to stun. And activity is fixed. Your effective power is capped at 1580. Ooh, all right. I will definitely try that.
My brother used to regale our people's children with the most fantastic stories. Twin kestrels who shared one heart and led a flock of birds against an unstoppable storm. A dragon born into the palm of a maiden's hand, but one day grew so large that it devoured the entire world. He spun tales about the Elixni, too. Weavers who transformed into wolves. Dancers who became devils.
You're baiting me. It won't work. I've seen what your influence does. Mizrax thinks he can make peace with the last city. His daughter tells stories like your Aldrin.
And the world is better for them. Aren't you tired, Aramis? I am.
Now you're wasting my time.
All people like you and I have is time. I spend mine thinking about everything I've lost. And what I'd give to get it back. You wonder the same.
Do not presume to know my mind.
You named your house Salvation, like something straight out of Aldrin stories. Ido's stories. We both want the best for the future. But we've pretended to be people we're not for so long that we've forgotten what else we are. Not just a queen. Not just a Kel. A sister. A mother. Aramis? Are you there?